Good morning everyone. So today let's start the new topic, that is angiosperm. So in the plant kingdom, actually earlier we have studied about algae, isn't it? Then after algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperm, and finally we have reached the angiosperm. That is, this is the highest evolved and advanced group of plants. So sir, around us whatever flowering plants we see, that constitutes the angiosperms. Okay, so earlier actually if we see the phylogenetic hierarchy, then we will observe that algae, it is succeeded by moss or bryophytes, which is succeeded by pteridophytes, and finally the higher plants. Okay, so these angiosperms, they are present in all type of conditions. That means they can present in hot areas, okay, in colder areas, then in wet areas, dry areas, everywhere it is present in every conditions. Okay, they may be parasitic, saprophytic, marine, terrestrial, then they may be epiphytes. So as these are advanced groups, so all type of plants and all type of different varieties are observed in this particular group of plant. Their lifespan also varies from 2 weeks to 43,000 years. Now 2 weeks, if we say, then it is, for example, Borrevia repens, which may exist for only 2 weeks or such that, and then Lomentia tasmanica, it survives for almost about 43,000 years. Okay, then the size of the plants may also vary. In angiosperm we see the smallest water plants, Wolffia, which is about less than 0.1 millimeter. Okay, then we see the tallest plant, that is Eucalyptus regnans. Okay, then the plant body, it may be sporophytic, that means it may be herb, shrub or trees. Okay, then it may be twiners also, trailers also, climbers also. Then the roots are well developed, tape root or adventitious roots may be there. Then the stem is also well branched and properly developed. Okay, okay, now the branchings are there. Okay, some stem may be erect, some may be underground, some may be subaerial, like that. Different types of stem also we will observe. Leaves are also different types, simple leaves, compound leaves, pinnate leaves, palmate leaves. Okay, so some will develop from axillary buds. All these varieties are observed in this particular group of plant kingdom. Got it? Then the vascular strands. There is a proper vascular strand, that means xylem and phloem are there, which are possessing all the main cell. That means we know that xylem possesses of 4 cells, tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fiber. All these are present in this angiospermic plants. Similarly, the phloem consists of sieve tubes, sieve plates, phloem parenchyma, phloem fiber. All these 4 cells are also present in this angiospermic plants. Now they help in conduction, xylem for conduction of water and minerals, and phloem for conduction of food. Now their arrangement are also again differently arranged. Now in pteridophytes, as we have seen the stellar structure, but here actually what happens, the vascular bundles, the xylem and phloem are arranged in bundles, and so they may be arranged in different manners. Sometimes they may be conjoined, collateral, open, close and dark. These different terms we use for describing the vascular strands. Okay, then secondary growth is observed in case of dicot plants where cambium tissue is present, so there we observed a secondary growth. But in monocot, actually due to absence of cambium tissue, we do not observe the secondary growth. Then flower is actually the main reproductive structure of the angiosperms. Got it? So now you can see that I have drawn a diagram of the flower. So here, this is the main reproductive part, which consists of 4 holes. 4 holes means these are the main reproductive, accessory and reproductive holes of a flower. The calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. This you have already studied in your school levels also. The calyx is the green part, okay. Corolla is the colorful part. and basic function of these two is to protect the reproductive order. Essential holes, androecium is the male reproductive part and gynoecium is the female reproductive part. Okay, now in angiosperms, actually the microsporophyll. Now what microsporophyll, I hope you have remembered, in case of bryophytes and radiophytes, we have studied about microsporophylls. So microsporophyll, they show reduction in the sterile tissue. Okay, and it actually here anthers are developed. These possess 4 microsporangia which develop order pollen sac which bears the microspores. Then the megasporophylls, these are actually rule to form the carpels. Now carpels means this this one, the gynoecium. Okay, the individual part is called carpel, which consists of stigma, style and ovary, and this rules off to form the carpel, megasporophyll. And it consists of the stigma, style, ovary, ovary being the vessel swollen portion. Okay, then here pollination may also be different. It may be pollinated by wind, birds, bats, animals, by human beings, water, wind, etc. So different mechanisms may be there for pollination. And pollination means the transfer of pollens from the anther to the stigma of the flowers, so the sexual reproduction can take place. Okay, then the female gametophyte, that is the embryo sac. It is a 7-cell or 8-nucleate state which is well developed. Okay, then double fertilization. Actually double fertilization means what? We know what is fertilization, isn't it? That means when the male and female gamete fuse together to form the zygote, then we call it as fertilization. Double fertilization means angiosperms possess the speciality to fertilize, being fertilized twice. Okay, that means 2 male gametes are formed. One male gamete fuses with the egg to form the zygote and the other male gamete fuses with the definitive nucleus to form the endosperm. An endosperm is a nutritive food-laden tissue which provides nourishment to the developing embryo. Got it? And this is triploid. In case of gymnosperm, we found that the endosperm is haploid, but in case of angiosperm, the endosperm is triploid. Okay, you remember the basic difference. Then the ovary, which gets developed into the fruit. Okay, so different type of fruit also we will get through: fruit, false fruit, aggregate fruit. So that we will study in our later classes. So all these things we will get, but these are actually the main basic parts which are observed in case of the angiospermic plant. Okay, now the flower, which is a very important part of the plant, angiospermic plant, because it consists of the main reproductive parts. Okay, and the fertilization also here, the double fertilization is important. Then triple fusion also we will observe. Triple fusion means the formation of endosperm when a haploid and a diploid cell fuse together to form the triploid endosperm. That particular process is known as triple fusion. Okay, the ovary gets developed into the fruit, the ovule develops into the seed. Okay, these are important parts. Then monocot and dicot plant we will get in case of angiosperms. Monocot means where one cotyledon is present in the seed and in the embryo or seed, and when 2 cotyledons are present, then it is known as a dicot plant. Okay, and already I have mentioned in case of secondary growth that the monocots do not possess the cambium tissue, for which they cannot show the secondary growth. But in contrast to that, the dicots, they possess the secondary growth, for which they shows they possess cambium, for which they shows the secondary growth. Okay, so go through these things in relation to angiospermic plants. Go through the books. These points are important. You have to study them properly. And in our later classes, we will go through them details in every part. Okay, so this is the basic thing. The terms are simple, new, and especially the scientific names. When we are studying about the size, we have to study what is the different type of size. Okay, smallest plant, tallest plant, then lifespan, which lives for short period, which lives for longer period. All these things are important and we have to study them properly.